so tonight, just down on one of the mate's farms. Got the river behind me there. Gonna have a quick look for some freshwater crayfish. Hopefully get a few and have a quick cook up. I was actually at work the other day thinking about freshwater crayfish and yeah, got me chomping at the bit to get out here and try and catch some. So should be good. There's usually a few around here and all the watercress and the reeds and stuff like that in the river, so have a quick look and see what we can do, see what we come up with. I was looking for bits of weed that you could probably pull up, because they like to sit under things, and the weed like that, watercress, reeds, and you just pull the weed up. Hopefully no water goes in my boots, and they're usually sitting under there. Not under that one, is a bigger one. No nippers though. Beauty. Another little one. Oh, there's one right by my finger. Quite a few under this this bit of grass here. One, heaps of little ones. And those big ones. Roll that back over. Look over here. Sweet little catch out of that one. Few in there. And the next clump.
Awesome little spot. Nice clear river.
Grass. there. Another little one there. Got one out of it. What you doing, boy?
So if you don't know what watercress is, that's all of that greenery there is growing in the water behind me. And if you boil it with some pork bones or bacon bones, bacon hock, boil it for, I don't know, an hour maybe or whatever, until it's cooked, it's actually really nice. Well, that's how I find the nicest way to eat it is anyway. And yeah, grows all over the place here in New Zealand. Don't know if it grows. Surely it grows in other countries, but yeah, I'm not too sure. But yeah, it's really good. I'm pretty sure you can eat it raw, I think. Actually not too bad raw. Not. Yep, no. Don't do that. Boil it. It's way better. Yeah. So I'll carry on trying to catch some crayfish. Small one there. Heaps more ones that are a lot smaller than this, but the biggest out of that lot. Go to the next spot. So I've got a few now. No real massive ones, but I'll just chuck them in the pot, get a bit of kindling, and then light a fire and cook them up. Now in New Zealand, it's got no nippers. In New Zealand there's two species of freshwater crayfish. This one here is the North Island one, and the South Island, the nippers here have a lot more spikes on them. Try and get a clear view of that. Like on the nippers, they have a heap of spikes on them. But yeah, so I'll get this fire started and have an entree.
So what I'm doing here is just making a square little hut. So I'm gonna put a fire starter in the middle. Gets enough airflow through the whole thing, and it should light up pretty quick. Nice dry kindling there. Got some bigger bits here to hold the flame. Go. I've been on here for a little while now. Beautiful. They're ready. Been on the fire for a little while now, they're nice and orange. They're a little bit fiddly to eat though. Like what you have to do. If you see that, just twist the head, then it comes off. Got all that gunk in there. Take those little legs off. And then the first two little shell pieces on its tail, you can break those off. And then it should just pop out. And you got that beautiful bit of crayfish meat there. Mmm, so good. Now obviously you need to catch a heap of these to have a good feed, but it's good just to have a taster. Brings back a lot of memories. again. Look at that. Those two pieces, first two pieces of the shell off. And bang. Beautiful. That's so good. Yep. So ends another mission. But yeah, next time I think I'll definitely come and stay out here. Catch a few trout. A few more crayfish. Good night away, actually.